Welcome to the kickoff of the 2017 Art Journal Adventure. Once again, this is a year-long project, though you can begin at any time, and we did have lots of people who jumped in after a few weeks, after several months. It really doesn't matter. The goal is always to get everyone creating on a consistent basis, so whether you jump in July or you do it here in January, it's all good. Unlike 2016, where I was responsible for each week's prompts and Bonnie Irvin filled in on occasion, this year, Bonnie is going to alternate. We're going to go back and forth. She'll do one week, I'll do the next. And she's such a wonderful artist. This way, everybody really gets to experience more of her art, her techniques, and her ideas. Prompts are going to vary from simple suggestions to somewhat more elaborate techniques. As I said, the goal is always to get us creating on a consistent basis. The Art Journal Adventure Facebook group will continue. I know a lot of you are already members. I would encourage anyone who isn't to jump in and join us there. It is a quote-unquote closed group, which means you have to ask to join, but that's just a Facebook formality. Everyone is welcome. In 2016, I used, well, this is it, in fact. I used the Dilusions Square Craft Journal. This year, I'm going to go in a slightly different direction. I have another project that you'll see in a video at one point. It's unrelated to the Art Journal Adventure, but the format is kind of similar to what you see here. This is hot press watercolor paper, and I'll talk about that in 1 second. It's cut to 9 inches by 10 inches. So I start with a 9 by 12 sheet, I lop off 2 inches, and I have my 9 inch by 10 inch piece. You can see that I'm working with loose sheets. There's that video I mentioned a moment ago. That's going to demo how I plan to bind all of these together. It's really simple. It uses Dina Wakely's media tape, but it's a nice, sturdy, effective binding, and I like the way that it looks. I'm enamored with the idea of working in loose pages. I think it's going to be a lot easier than working in a journal where it's, you know, stitched signatures in a binding. I'm ready to try something a little bit different. So for 2017, I'm working with, and this is, let's see, who makes this? This is Global Art Materials, I think it is. This is their fluid watercolor paper book. And it's bound in a block like what you see here. The edges are glued on two sides and you use a palette knife to slip through here and get them out. 9 by 12, as I said, I'm cutting it down to 9 by 10. Now, why am I going with hot press? Because I use cold press watercolor paper almost routinely. The reason that I'm doing that is because I got spoiled by the paper that's in the Dilusions journals. It's this mixed media paper, and it's very smooth. So I wanted to stick with smooth. I kind of liked working with that. Sometimes there are techniques that I'm not super thrilled about the way that they work on cold press watercolor paper. So this allows me to pretty much do anything I want. So what I'm doing is, 2017 is the year of the rooster. Not that I'm big into the Chinese calendar or anything like that, but I thought it was as good a place to begin the year as any. So what I'm working with, and there goes my palette knife onto the floor. What I'm working with is a piece of the Tattered Angels Mixed Media Origins paper. This one happens to be called Barn, and it has this great, is it a chicken, is it a rooster? I have no idea, but it's on there and I really liked it. So I've colored mine, and it looks nothing like a Rhode Island red, any kind of a chicken you've ever seen, but let's take it off the colored background. The colors make me happy. I really like them. So I took some colors of Color Wash, I took some colors of Dilusions and Distress Spray Stains, and I put them on here. I just wanted this kind of loose pattern, and I like the way that the colors work with what I've done here. These are just Derwent Color Soft Pencils, which actually work beautifully on this paper from Tattered Angels. That Origins paper is not paper. It's unlike anything I've ever seen before. There's got to be a plastic component in there somehow. It has a slight texture to it. It takes the pencils really beautifully. It takes, if you want to work with color in your water brushes or something like that, I've done that too. It works really well. There's, again, that whole video will be coming that talks about these papers, talks about what I'm doing with them and how I eventually bind them together, and that's what I'm going to mimic here. So the one thing that I do want to do, because of course this is me, is I'm going to come in with one of the Lindy's Starburst sprays. I don't want to obliterate what's here. I just want to get a nice thin layer of glimmer on here. So this is Grab a Guy Gold. Couple of quick spritz. That's about all I'm going to do. I like the dot pattern that I've gotten. So I need to dry this, and then I'm going to come back. We'll talk about what I'm going to put on the cover. I do want to say 2017 Art Journal Adventure in some way, shape, or form. I just haven't quite figured that out yet, but that's what's coming next. Everyone has their own unique handwriting style, and obviously that's going to impact what your letters look like. Whether we're all using uppercase block letters or there's some cursive thing that we're doing, your style is going to be different than mine. How I write, and most of the time it's pretty messy, how I write affects how I form those letters. During week 8 of the 2016 Art Journal Adventure, where the prompt was lettering, one of the things that was the most important for me that came out of that week was the importance of a guideline. Whether you are lettering in a straight line, whether you want to letter around a shape like a circle, or you want to letter on a curvy line, having that guideline in place is really important. So to put the guideline in, I'm using this see-through ruler. So I came along here, 1 inch from the edge, and I put my guideline in. For the 2017, I want to say my guideline was up about 3/4 of an inch. Now, I've kind of mimicked what I've done here. One of the things that I've learned is that I don't letter on camera particularly well. So I've kind of set this up so that I can show you a little bit about what I did. I've got a guideline. I've started to do some lettering. If you find that it's difficult to keep your letters all the same height, put another line in along the top that you can use so that you can work to keep the height of the letters the same by keeping them between these two lines. Now, this is obviously not correct, but for whatever it is that you want to do, and some people find that really helpful. To do the actual lettering, I'm using a Pitt pen. I'm working with black. This is the F fine tip, and I've already done a little bit of this here. But all I do is come along and go over my pencil marks, and then I'll come back and erase. One of the nice things about Pitt pens is that they dry virtually instantly, and if you come in and erase, you're not going to smudge your lettering. And there's nothing worse than loving what you did and coming to erase the guidelines and discovering that you've smudged your ink. That's not fun at all. The other thing that I did to just kind of make this a little bit more interesting, and if I turn this, see these three little dots? I've used them on the letters. Now, I haven't quite finished over here yet. I've done the 2017, and I've been consistent. So, for example, on the A, the three dots are always here. If you come over here, you see them. So for this, I've used a Pitt, an XS, an extra super fine tip, although quite honestly, the super fine probably would have been okay. So if I come over here and I look at my T, I can see that my three dots are right about here. All this does is just add a little bit of interest. That way the letters have a little bit of life. They're not quite so flat and so plain. If you want to add dots or curly cues, if you want to come in with another color and add shadows or drop shadow kinds of things, you certainly can do that. So what else am I going to do? Quite honestly, I'm not certain. I might put something in here about the year of the rooster. I'm thinking about doing some sort of a border. I know that because this paper has some sort of a plastic component in it, I'm going to use the Aileen's Super Thick Tacky Glue. It's a multi-surface glue, so I know that it will properly adhere my rooster to my cover. I'm going to position this in some fashion. I'm not entirely sure how yet. And when I'm done, I'll come and I'll trim the rest of this tail off. And as I said, what exactly else I'm going to do to this, I'm not entirely certain. But what I can tell you for certain is that there'll be photos on the Joggles blog. So whether you come to reference a prior 2016 week, or you want to come in and start following all the way through 2017, the blog is there. There'll be a post each week. We're not going to do videos on a weekly basis. It's going to be posts with static photos and text that go along with it. But I'll take a picture of this when it's done so that you can see where I ended up. Now, the one thing that I will tell you, I've already got some smudge on the back here. It is what it is. I'll just work over it. So we're looking forward, Bonnie and I, to seeing you, hopefully in the Facebook group, whether you come in to lurk or you want to join in and post photos of your work and talk about what you've done or ask for advice. We're all there to help. It is a no-criticism group. We encourage everyone to come in. We want you to be comfortable and to have a really good time.